Hello everyone, today is the day 19 of 100 days of code, and today in this video we'll be discussing how to find the power of 2 if a number is a power of 2 or not. Okay, so basically the powers of 2 are 1, because 2 power 0 is 1, 2, 4, 8 and so on. Okay, so how to find out if a number is a power of 2? Let's see what do these numbers in the binary form look like. In the binary form, 1 is nothing but 001, 2 is 010, 4 is 100, 8 is 1000, right? If I add here 0 with the starting numbers, it doesn't make any difference, but we can observe a pattern. 1 has here 1, like the last digit 1, 2 has the second last digit 1, 4 has the second digit 1, and 8 has the first digit 1. As we keep on increasing the values, we will get the 1 left shifted by 1 place than the previous one, right? And one more thing you can observe, that after the first 1, there is no other number having 1. 1 means it's 1 here, and what are the numbers after it? All are 0, right? So how to find out if it's a number of this type or not? To do that, what we can do is, what is 1000 minus 1? When you do minus 1, we'll get 111, right? This is the answer which you get when we subtract with 1. And this is nothing but 7. 8 minus 1 is 7, right? Now what we can do, when we get this number, if we AND, okay, 100 and 0111, if you do AND operation between these both, we'll get the answer as 0, right? Why? Because 000 with 111, it will give me 0, and 1 with 0 will give me 0. So anyways, take any number, and when we do N and N minus 1, okay, among any of these numbers, if we do N and with N minus 1, suppose that 4, okay, 4 is 0100, okay, 0100, and with 4 minus 1, which is 3. So when we do 3 here, it will be 0011, right? So this is the number which we have. When we do AND operation between these both, what we will get is 0000, right? Because 0 with 0 is 0, 1 and 0, 0011, so finally we'll get a 0. So what we can observe is, if it's a power of 2, then we'll get the 0 when we perform this operation, right? Else if I take like 9, okay, let's take as 9. 9 is nothing but 1001, right? 9's value is 1001. When we do 9 with 8, will I get 0? 11 will give me 1000, so I'm getting value as 1000. This is not equal to 0, right? 100 I got when I did AND with both of these, I got a non-zero number. Whenever I get a non-zero number, that means 9 is not a power of 2. Whenever a number is power of 2, if you do the AND operation with the number previous of that one, like 100, the previous is 7, when you do AND operation, we will get a 0. By this check, what we can say is, the given number is power of 2 or not. Let's write the code here. Suppose that I take the number N is equal to 8. Okay, let's take 32. Then what I will do is, if N and N minus 1, I am doing the AND operation, is equal to 0, then see out, it's a power of 2. Okay, means yes, I will see out. Yes means it's a power of 2. Else if it's coming as a non-zero number, when we do AND operation between that number and the previous number, that means it's not a, what do you say, it's not a power of 2. Okay, so let's run this code and see. Here I am getting as no, okay, but actually the number I have taken 32, 32 is actually power of 2. Why am I getting here no? Let's see why I am getting here no. So basically the mistake which I made here is, what I did is 32 and 32 minus 1, which will give me 0, right? So when I am equating this with 0, that means it's false value, right? If it's false value, then I should get the output as no, right? If this number is 0, that means this value has become false, so this will not run, right? When this will not run, I should get the output as yes. For example, what I mean is, see, I am getting here 32, okay? I am getting here 32, right? 32, this answer should give me 0. If 0 means if false, if it's false, then this will not run, this will run. If it's false means it's a power of 32, if it's a power of 2, right? In the power of 2 only, I'll get a 0, which will make it false, and this will not run, and this will run, right? So, in this case, I'll get the correct answer. See, I am getting here yes, and if I type here like 31, I should get as no. In 31, this value will not become false, therefore it will be true. And when it is true, this loop will statement will run, which is no. Okay. Since 31 is not a power of 2, I am getting here no. Okay. So this was for the day 19 of 100 days of code. And thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one.